Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_049_DIABM where you see it. You can also download this file on the website. If you don't have access to the exercise file, just sit down and watch the video. Go to the application button, the big red letter A, and click this down arrow. Move the mouse cursor and select the Save As button. This will bring the save drawing as a dialog box. Rename this file to 00_050_DIABM. Look at the file of type section, AutoCAD 2018. You cannot open this file in any earlier version of AutoCAD. So if you plan to open this file in any earlier version of AutoCAD, click this down arrow and select that version. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007 and click the Save button. In the last tutorial, we modeled the fascia board of our roof. In this tutorial, we're going to design the Sufit. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the Freeze command. At the Select object on which layer to be frozen prompt, click the roof, AutoCAD freeze the roof. Press Escape to get out of the command. Select the fascia board, right click and select similar. Right click, isolate object. Make the cabbage layer the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. Zoom into this area. At the specified start point prompt, click on this area. At the specified next point or undo prompt, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 100 mm. Press enter. Press enter to end the line the command. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the polyline command. At specified start point prompt, start at end point of this line. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this corner. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Click on this endpoint and snap to this endpoint object snap. Type 600. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. When we isolate the fascia board, the AutoCAD reveal another error in this area. If you have the same error, zoom into this area. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling panel, and select the box command. Click on this corner, move the mouse cursor, and click on this corner. Move up and click. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the Union command. At the Select object prompt, select this object and this object. Press enter. Zoom out. Use the mouse wheel to zoom out. Hold the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom into this area. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. At specify first object prompt, click on this area, move up and type 100 mm. Press enter. Press enter. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the polyline command. At specify start point prompt, snap at the end point of this line that you just draw. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this angle. Use the perpendicular object snap to snap. If you pick the wrong point, you can type undo key to undo the last sequence. Click perpendicular object snap, perpendicular object snap. As you can see, now I pick the wrong point. If you have a same situation, type key on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD undo the last segment. Click to the perpendicular object snap. You can also turn the visual style to 2D wireframe, but I find it more easy to in the realistic visual style. Click snap on this perpendicular object snap. Snap again, I snap the wrong point. Type U on your keyboard and press enter if you have a same situation. Snap, snap, snap. Move the mouse cursor and type 600 mm. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Right click the UCS and select fish. Hover the mouse cursor to the face of this fascia board and press enter. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the polyline command. As specified first point prompt, click on this area. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Snap on this point. Hold shift key, middle mouse button. Snap to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control, click realistic, and select 2D wireframe. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. As specified offset distance prompt, type 100 millimeter, press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape to get out of the CAD format. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline, click on this clip and snap it to the perpendicular of this line. Zoom out, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button. Click on this polyline, click on this clip and snap perpendicular to this line. Press escape. Select this polyline, click this clip and snap to this endpoint. Click this clip, snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. And specify offset distance from type 600. Press enter. Select this polyline and offset it inside. Select this polyline and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom in into this area, use a window selection and select this line. Hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the visual style control, click 2D wireframe and select realistic. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. And specifying start point prompt. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and click. Hold down the shift key, right click and select the perpendicular object snap. Snap to this point, press escape. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the polyline command. Snap from this point to this end point. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual side control, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Select this polyline, right click and polyline join. Select this line and this line, hit press enter on your keyboard. Press escape. Press enter to repeat the polyline command. At the select polyline or multiple points, select this polyline, select the joint option, select this, press enter, press escape, select this polyline, the two polyline is being joined into one, press escape to get out of the command, right click the UCS and select the freeze option, as it's a choice of solid, surface or mesh point, hover the mouse cursor into this feature board and click, press enter to accept. Go to the visual style control, click this and select realistic. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At specifying first point prompt, zoom in into this area and click on this vertex. At specifying next point prompt, hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in into this area and pick this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now click in this area and use a crossing window to select. Hold down the shift key and click to deselect the solid. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At specify base point prompt, click the base point of this line. At the specify second point prompt, snap to the end point of this line. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. We have an error to correct in this area. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the union command. Select the solid and the solid. Press enter. Now go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, click on this face. Now move the mouse cursor, zoom in closely and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Now use a window selection to select this short line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. And specify start point from, start the polyline from this point, snap to this point and this point, press escape. Go to the visual style control, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Zooming into this area, use a crossing window selection to select this polyline. Hold down the shift key and click into this area to deselect the other polyline. Hit delete on your keyboard. Zoom out. Go to the visual style and select realistic. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. At specify start point prompt, click on this area, hover the mouse cursor to this area and move up, type 100 millimeter, press enter, start the line and click on this vertex, this corner, click on this corner, hover the mouse cursor into this corner, click on this corner. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. at the specified offset distance from type 100 millimeter. Press enter. Select this polyline and offset it out. Press escape. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At specify face point prompt, start the polyline from this endpoint. Zoom in into this area, snap to the perpendicular of this edge, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button, snap to this edge, this edge, this edge, snap perpendicular of this edge, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button, snap to this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit, move the mouse cursor and click into this area. Press escape. Right click the UCS and select the face option. As you select face of solid, surface or mesh prompt, move the mouse cursor and hover it to this face. Press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the polyline command. Zoom in into this area and snap to this endpoint and this endpoint. Press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel, select the offset command. And specify offset distance from type 100 millimeter and press enter. Select this object and offset it up. Press escape. Let's try to fillet this line and this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Select this line. There is an error. Let's change the visual style to realistic and see. Alright, this line is drawn in the inside face and this line is drawn in the outside face. Let's see if we can correct this error. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Use a crossing window and select both the line and the solid. Hold down the shift key and select the solid to deselect it. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the specifying base point prompt, click on this edge. At specifying second prompt, click on this edge to move this line. Now hold down the shift key and middle mouse button to orbit to see the result inside. Go to the visual style and change to 2D wireframe. Now select this line, move the mouse cursor and snap to the intersection of this line. Select this line, move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this line. Press escape, select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select the world option. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. And specify offset distance from type 600, press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Press escape. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. And specify base point prompts. Click on this endpoint. Now move the mouse cursor into this endpoint and type 600. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Start the line from this endpoint to this endpoint. Press enter, press escape. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the ray command. At specify start point prompt, zoom in into this area and click on this point. At specify through prompt point prompt, click at the endpoint of this line. Press escape. Right click the UCS and select the face option. At the face, select face of solid or surface prompt. Click on this face, press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, modify panel, click this panel and select the trim command. Select this object, press enter, trim off this line, press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select the object. At the select object prompt, select this line, zoom in into this area and select to the extreme end and hit this line, delete this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Select this line and this line. Select the UCS, right click and select the object. Select this object. Go to the visual style, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Now right click the UCS and select rotate axis, X axis. Move the mouse cursor. Make sure that the Y axis points in this direction. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. and specify face point prompt. Move the mouse cursor and click on this endpoint. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Go to the visual style control, click the realistic and select 2D wireframe. Zoom in into this area and use the cursing window. Click here and click to select. Hold down the shift key and select the rectangle to deselect it. Hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. And specify start point prompt. Click at this endpoint of this line. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint of this line. Press escape. Click on this area and move down and click. Hold down the shift key and deselect the rectangle. Right click, polyline, join. Select this line and this line. Press enter. Press escape to deselect. Now these three lines is being joined. Moving into this area. Now right click, polyline and select the close option. The gap is being closed. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. As specifying first point prompt, click the end point of this line. Move the mouse cursor, snap to this area, but don't click. Type 100 millimeter, press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Use the endpoint object snap of the 100 millimeter line you just draw into this position and click. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in and snap to this vertex. Move the mouse cursor. Snap to this vertex. 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 Press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. I specify offset distance from type 600 and press enter. Select the polyline that you just draw and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the polyline command. And specify start point prompt. Click on this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this line. Press escape. Now select this polyline, right click, polyline, join. Select this line, press enter. Now select the close option to close the polyline. Press escape. Select the object to see that if it's been converted. The polyline is being converted and closed into one object. Press escape. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start from this point to this point. Press escape. Select this polyline, right click, polyline, joint. Select this and press enter. Press escape. Select AutoCAD, convert this object into polyline. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control, click and select realistic. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Use the crossing window to select the polyline and the solid. Hold down the shift key and select the solid. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. And specify base point prompt. Click at this endpoint. Now move the mouse cursor and hover it here. Type 600 millimeter, press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Click at the endpoint of this line and move the mouse cursor, snap to this endpoint. Press escape. Now to get this right, we need to use another type of line, which is a 3D polyline. Change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline command. Start from this point, endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Now, zoom into this area, click and use a crossing window to select. Use crossing window to select this area. use a crossing window to select here. Hold down the shift key and select the solid to deselect it. Use a crossing window to select this area. Now hold down the shift key, click in this area and click outside. Hit delete on your keyboard. Now click on this object. It's being converted into one object. Now select this polyline, click on this grid and snap into this point. Press escape. Now select this 3D polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Click on this area and move into this direction. Click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Select this polyline and this line. Type oops on your keyboard to bring the deleted object. Go to the visual style control, click the 3D wireframe and select realistic. Now, let's convert this polyline that we already drew into surface to see the results before we proceed to the bottom feasible. To do that, let's create a layer. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the layer properties. This being the layer properties manager. Click the new button. Rename this layer to Sufit. Click the color switches and select the index color 255. Click OK. Close the layer properties manager. Now click down arrow and select the Sufit layer to make it the current layer. Select this polyline, right click, select similar. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the plan command. AutoCAD converts all this polyline into surface. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation to see the results. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit and see the results. Now go to the status, go to the quick access toolbar and click the undo button. Undo. Change the visual style to from realistic to 2D wireframe. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. And specify extrusion edge point. Zoom in and click to this endpoint. Press enter to repeat the extrude command. Add the select object to extrude point. Click on this polyline. Press enter. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Now right click, select this line, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 3D polyline command. At specify face point point, click on this point, snap to this point, type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point, type C and press enter to close the figure. Now zoom in into this area, select this object, go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and select the plan to convert this surface into plan. Now use a window selection to select all the objects. Zoom in into this area, hold down the shift key and click this surface to deselect it. Click the surface to deselect it, hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the visual style and select realistic. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Now let's move down and continue our fisher boat in the bottom side of this wall. Select this wall, this solid, and this fisher boat. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Right click, isolate object. Now let's correct this problem. Let's try to subtract this object from this. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. As specify first point, move and snap to the end point of this line. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. As select object to extrude point, select this line, press enter. Move the mouse cursor to the top. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the slide command. Select this solid, press enter. Type S on your keyboard and press enter. Click on the surface. Add the select slice object to keep or keyboard prompt. Press enter to select the keyboard option. Select the surface and hit delete select the line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D tool tab, solid edge panel, click the down arrow and select the separate command. At the select 3D solid object, select the solid, press enter to exit. Now select this portion and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D tool tab, solid edit panel and select the union command. Select this solid and press enter. Go to the home tab, layer panel, make the cabbage layer the current layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At specifying first point point, move the mouse cursor and snap to this point. Move up and type 100 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Press enter to repeat the line command. At the specified start point point, click at this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and type 100 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Press enter. Start the line from this endpoint. Move up. Move up and type 100 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to end the line command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At specifying first start point prompt, click on this area. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 100. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start from this endpoint. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Snap to the perpendicular of this line. Perpendicular to this edge. Perpendicular to this edge. Snap. I snap into the wrong point. If you have a simple fusion, type U on your keyboard and press enter to undo the last segment. Snap. Press escape. Press enter to start the polyline command. Start the polyline from this point. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and use the polar tracking snap. Type 100 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Press enter to repeat the polyline command again. At specified start point, press enter. When you are in a line or polyline command, at the specified first point prompt, if you press enter, AutoCAD starts the line from the last line that you pick, last point that you pick. Snap to this perpendicular, zoom in into this area and snap to this area, snap to this area. Press enter. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit around, zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start the polyline at the end point of this line. Snap to the end point of this edge. Snap to the end point of this edge to this edge. Press enter. Now right click the UCS and select the face option. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the face of this feature, but press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Zoom in into this area and snap. Snap to this end point. Snap to this endpoint, snap to this endpoint, move down and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Select this line, click on this script and snap it to this endpoint. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance prompt, type 100 millimeter, press enter. Select this polyline and offset it out. Press escape. Select this polyline, hit delete. Now select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, click on this grip and snap to the endpoint of this line. Press escape. Right click the UCS and select the face option. Select this face and click. Press enter to accept. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Click on this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, and this endpoint. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At specified offset distance prompt, type 100 millimeter and press enter. Select this line and offset. Press escape. Select this polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline, click on this clip and snap to this endpoint. Select this line, press escape, select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At specified offset distance from type 600 millimeter, press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Select this line and offset it inside. select this line and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the polyline command. Start the polyline from this point, move the mouse cursor, turn on the auto mode and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this polyline and this polyline, this polyline and this polyline. Press escape. Go to the home tab, drop panel and select the polyline command. Start the polyline from this point to this point. Press enter. Select the polyline, right click, polyline, join. Select this polyline, press enter. Select the close option to close this keyboard. Press escape. Go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Select this polyline, right click, polyline and select the close option. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. As specified start point prompt, click on this endpoint. Turn on the polar tracking and snap to 45 degrees. Type 600 millimeter and press enter. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the visual style, click the realistic and select 2D wireframe. Select the polyline, right click, polyline and select the joint option. Select this polyline, press enter, select the close option. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click the down arrow and select the Sufit layer. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object point, select this line, press enter, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 600 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the extrude command. Select this line. Press enter. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 600. Press enter. Select this line. This polyline. Surface panel and click the plan command. Right click the drawing area. Isolate end object isolation. Go to the visual style and select realistic. Select this fisher boat, this surface, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the isolate command. Select this polyline and press enter to isolate this layer. Now use a window selection to select all these objects and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Then go to the home tab, layer panel and click the on isolate command. Click the Thor command. Go to the custom view. Go to the view controller and click the custom view. Select SE isometric. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit and see the results. Alright, we're going to stop this tutorial at this point. The surface is being completed. In the next tutorial, we're going to design the ceiling of our model. Go back to the view controller and click the custom view. Click the SE isometric, go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.